So do you think the Mars, like all the stuff that we have, the Mars station, the Mars vehicle, would it look a little bit like SpaceX inside? Just, you know, this touch screen and everything is there on the go? Ah. And the machine will have artificial intelligence and do the rest for us?
I don't know. I think there'll be everything that you can, you know, it's the same for planes, designed for cars, designed. It doesn't go maybe as fast as for space, but you always tend to unburden the human, because the human is the source of error in most systems. And that's just how it is. I mean, you can be as good a pilot, the best pilot in the world, you're still going to make mistakes, because...
Don't talk too bad of the astronauts, because they will send rovers then.
No, but you're not, I mean, a human is not good. If you ask a human to watch one parameter for 6 hours straight, single variation, it's impossible to do. Nobody can do this. We're just not wired for this. Automatic system can do this. It's the easiest thing. So you just have to share the responsibilities in a smart way. And that's what the agencies are trying to do. So yeah, I'm hoping it's going to be more streamlined, maybe not all touch screen, maybe some Velcro, maybe some buttons and
some
switches,
real buttons,
some buttons. But yeah, the more you can integrate, the better it is. Already on station, we have tablets now. Before, we used to have lots of paper procedures, taking down notes, etc. We don't do this anymore. So
we still have paper procedures for emergency.
Sure.
In case but that's the only one.
And there's a new printer on space station.
A new printer.
The thing I'm the most excited about, because actually I was looking forward to go back and just take a picture of the old printer as an embarrassment to the entire space community, because I can't give the brand, but it was really from, I'm not going to say the 80s, but almost.
And it changed the running system.
It never worked. And I think the biggest source of time loss on station. Maybe that's just me, but now there's a new one. So see, things are getting better. You'll see when you fly once, you come back a second time, you'll see things are going better. And that makes you feel good. I mean, we're going in the right direction.
So you're looking forward to the new printer. I look forward to the second toilet in the US segment. So that will be the third toilet on the station. And I think once we go to a crew of 7 plus a direct handover with 4 or 5 more, 12 people on board, you need a third toilet.
Cool. So yeah, it's a different adventure. But I think in the end, you always end up ready. You always end up knowing more than you should. Because you want to be prepared.
It's like in school. I mean, in school, you also, when you go to the A level, a lot of people have the impression you learn 100%, and in life you need 5%. Mm-hmm. But that's not true, because you never know which 5% you need.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But one of the differences, like you were saying, the second time around, I'm not trying to know as much as the first time, and I'm not complacent, but. I have a better idea of what I should know and what is superfluous. And the first time around, I don't know what your opinion is, but there's no choice. I mean, you have to learn everything. You have to do your best. You have to also prove to the people that you can do the work. The second time around, you're more like, okay, so is that really important? No, I have Matthias. Matthias will know everything by heart, so I don't need to.
The pressure is like, I need to work hard, because there will be Thomas who knows everything.
So it's good. It's the good dynamics. But I think the second time around, it's more about what do I really need to know? How should I focus my effort more? And also how to pass the experience in a good way. You don't want to be that guy, you know, to tell everyone, oh, you should do this, oh, that's not how we do it, oh, you should do this, because that doesn't work. But on the other hand, you also don't want to sit back and don't use this experience. So you have to find the right way to tell very smart and very successful people and very knowledgeable people that, okay, look, there's also maybe this
to guide the team forward,
without you know, looking down on them, or without, and it's a difficult balance to strike. Yeah. So I'm learning. There's always something to learn.
There's
always something to
learn. You can even learn from a beginner, eh?
I know, absolutely. Yeah.